sometimes I feel like I'm walking on the edge of the world. Out in the storm of life, in a dead man's curve. I don't even know if tomorrow you'll still be my girl, my little girl. And I feel like I'm walking on the edge of the world. Edge of the world.
Dag Seegers, welcome to Uddevalla.
Well, thank you so much. It's nice to be here.
I think it's the first time in this town for you.
Yes, it is.
The last day you spent on an island, Orust, right near from here. Tell us about it. How have your days and evenings and nights been there?
It's been nothing but enjoyable for me. I'm looking at all these venues the same. They're all sold out, and then I'm playing for a bunch of people that are loving country western music, and I'm here to deliver.
But is it possible to get all this love and positivity inside you, because you get more and more and more? Can you get it inside you, your soul?
Yeah, it's been in my soul for quite some time. The popularity is I have an opportunity to share my love with other people. You know, I've always had the love of God in my soul. You know, whether I've been living under a bridge or whether I've been playing in front of 10,000, 5,000 people for a venue. You know, I've got the same element of love in my heart.
Prata kärlek med Doug Seegers, och vi pratar mest engelska, det får nog hålla till godo med. Nu ska vi också höra Doug sjunga på engelska. Of course we want to hear you sing and play the guitar.
Alrighty.
What do you want to play right now?
Well, I'd like to, I was thinking about that on the way here, and I thought maybe I'd play something that kind of talks about my past lifestyle. When I was living under a bridge and I was homeless, and it was only, incredibly enough, it was only a year ago that I was, you know, pretty much living out there as a free man.
Yeah, now you're captured in the studio.
I'm captured.
Please play for us.
Absolutely, see. Thank you very much. Here's a little song. I call this song Mr. Weevil, as in Bo Weevil.
Well, my name is Mr. Weevil, but my best friends all call me Bo. Well, my name is Mr. Weevil, but my best friends all call me Bo. Well, I'll be standing on the corner, 'cause I got no place to go. Well, I'm a little Bo Weevil, and it sure like to find me a hole. Well, I'm a little Bo Weevil, and it sure like to find me a hole. Well, I'm as hard as a rock, but I know when it's time to roll. I ain't got a blanket, a pillow, but I should find a bed. 20 feet off the interstate, somebody's tool shed. Maybe a manhole cover or a boxcar train. Sitting under the bridge, boys, it's all the same. Well, my name is Mr. Weevil, but my best friends all call me Bo. Well, my name is Mr. Weevil, but my best friends all call me Bo. Well, I'll be standing on the corner, 'cause I got no place to go. Well, I might be good, I might be bad, I might steal your girlfriend, 'cause I know I could. Put a 20 on the table to get the job done, 'cause I never heard of anyone having too much fun. Well, my name is Mr. Weevil, my best friends all call me Bo. Well, my name is Mr. Weevil, but my best friends all call me Bo. Well, I'll be standing on the corner, 'cause I got no place to go. Yes, I'll be standing on the corner, 'cause I got no place to go. Well, my name is Mr. Weevil, but my best friends all call me Bo. Baby, I gotta go.
Ooh. Miss Bo. No, your name is Dog. Dog? Seegers.
Yes, Seegers.
Right. Thank you very much for that.
Thank
here in
you.
Studio in Uddevalla. And this quite different life in Sweden, this exotic country.
It's beautiful. It really is beautiful. How I've been having a wonderful time here in Sweden. I was never in an airplane before I came to Sweden.
True.
Okay. Yeah.
And how many gigs has it been here?
My goodness, it's been we've been here for a couple of months now, and it feels like we've been doing a gig just about every day. Mm. We get a couple of days off every now and then, but we've been pretty much, you know, every day go to another venue, get in the truck and ride for hours and make the next show.
And that life, how is that for you?
It's a life that I've been out on the road, you know, with bands in the past. It hasn't been this much of a intensity, though, you know, it's never been like an everyday thing like this. This is a 3-month tour, and I've never done anything like this before. It's been wonderful, actually. People come up to me and they say, "Boy, you must be running out of energy, huh?" Mm. And I tell them, "Well, I got plenty of time to sleep in the truck on the way to the next job, so I'm not really running out of energy at all."
Do you exercise?
I do have some exercise in the morning, yeah. Yeah, I like to swim. You know, a lot of the motels that we go to, most of them have swim pools, and sometimes I'll take a swim in the pool. I was sitting in the sauna a couple of weeks ago, and they had some Cuban cigars over there at the motel. The motel was called the Havana. So I was sitting in the sauna smoking a Cuban cigar, and all of a sudden I just burst out laughing, thinking, I was homeless a year ago. Here I am with a Cuban cigar sitting in the sauna.
Kubansk cigar i en bastu, en bra bit ifrån hemlösheten. But, dog. Do people sometimes ask you, this story from the television, is it really, really true? Is there some fake in it, or is it a little...
No.
Do you get that question?
I do get the question, but I mean, you know, before this whole thing started, you know, I made a commitment to myself to make absolutely sure that anybody that did any articles on me or anything, I'm real persistent for keeping things honest. I get myself in trouble by being honest. All right. I mean, sometimes I talk too much about my past and my bad, you know, the bad days, you know. Mm. And it's got to be for me, you know. I don't want no bullshit about my life at all. I don't need the bullshit. I got plenty of real bullshit going on, you know.
Not right now.
Right.
No. People love you, all the Swedish audience that found you. Maybe is it mostly women, do you think? Or
no, it's not
audience?
Women. No, it's no? not. And when I play out, you know, they call it busking. When you play out on the street, mm-hmm. I've been a street performer mm-hmm. my entire life, and I will play out on the street until the day I die, actually. But for me, it's playing, it's reaching the children. You know, the children are like... For me, you know, it's like the way I look at children is like it's our responsibility to administer as much love as possible to these little children that are walking around on the earth, because that's the future of our world.
Världens framtid är barnen, och de är också en del av publiken. What do you play for the children? Do we have something for them?
Well, that's kind of embarrassing. I do actually. If you want to hear one of my kids' songs I play out on the street, do I really have to do this? I will.
I'd love to.
Well, I'm Sammy the Snake. I sound like the letter S. Oh, yes. Well, I'm Sammy the Snake, and I sound just like the letter S. I confess. I'm all wiggly and curly, and make no mistake, the sound the letter S is the sound I make so long. Yes,
more to it.
Oh, they, like, that's
the kid stuff, okay. You know, I mean, that's my biggest joy is playing kids' songs out on the street, you know, because the parents love it, I love it, the kids love it, and I get the chance to put my guitar in their little hands, and maybe they'll strum it a little bit, you know. It's just, that's what I'm supposed to do. I feel like that's what I'm supposed to do out there, and, you know, play for the children. That's my biggest joy, actually.
But maybe not tonight, there's so much children on Orust.
Right.
Many people love you. What's your opinion of yourself as an artist? What do you think, and what were your thoughts about yourself as a musician and artist before,
you know,
this happened?
I like that question because people are looking at me like I'm this incredible songwriter, you know, and maybe I have low self-esteem because for me, you know, people like Bob Dylan and Bruce Springsteen and you know, people like that to me are songwriters, you know. I don't really consider myself a great songwriter. I'm a person that just loves to write songs. And it's okay, you know. It's okay to just to be a person that loves to write songs. And when you think of how many horrible songs are out there that have hit number one already, and I figure, well, why can't I be one of those horrible songwriters out there with the number one song? I just love writing songs. I'm not a great songwriter at all.
But the rest, the singing, the voice.
Well,
the
guitar playing. Mom and my mother and father are both singers. I have all through my whole family singers in my family, and I love this. I was born loving singing. You know, I think the human voice is the most precious instrument there is. Really.
How much do you think about the future when you're right in this in Sweden now? How far into the future do you think?
Not very far. Like, for me, the future is tomorrow. And I just, you know, it's one day at a time, and I really can't predict the future, really. And I definitely don't worry about the future, you know, because for me, worrying about the future means you're not focused on the present as well as you should be. You know, for my life is one day at a time. I live it to the max. I get up in the morning and count my blessings that I get to live another day.
But can't there be a risk if you have this very positive period and this all love, and then maybe you don't get it all the rest of your life, that this period, do you know what I'm
looking for? I'm not so sure.
No, do I know what I'm looking for? No, but I mean, if it's a very contrast from your old life, and then you get this very positive, and then in the future, maybe if it's not...
Well,
like
I'll tell you what, you know, I'm looking at this whole career right now that we got a big, real strong buzz going on right now for my career, and I was just informed about 10 minutes ago, believe it or not, that the album rating is back up to number one again. So evidently it was at one and fell, and now it popped back up again. Now that's a blessing right there. But, you know, it's like if you took a snowball and you put it on the top of a hill and you started rolling the snowball down the hill, the snowball eventually grows to be a larger snowball as you're going down. And that's pretty much how I'm looking at my career, you know. I got that little snowball right now, and I'm just going to keep pushing it down that hill and try to make it as big as I possibly can. When it's, you know, when it stops going, you know, that's when I stop going. I'll just look back and just count my blessings at that point, that I had the opportunity to be there while I was, you know.
And that's right now, because we want to hear more.
That's right now.
From you. Can
you want to hear another song?
I really love to.
I got a gospel song that I actually, this is very, very new. I'm going to try and see if I can remember most of the words to it. But I've been wanting to write a gospel song because I haven't written one yet. I'd like to try this song for you guys right now. Will you take the hand of Jesus, let him purify your soul? Will you take that path to heaven with the streets all lined with gold? Well, brother, we're gonna welcome anyone who stumbles by. Won't you tell me if you wanna be in that place beyond the sky? I can see my grandma's fingers as they glide across the key. I can hear her as she's playing that old-fashioned melody. I can see my uncle playing with his banjo on his knee.
while my daddy softly singing Rock of Ages left for me. Rock of Ages, Rock of Ages left for me. Well, I know you've got your habits, and I know you've got your pain, and I know you're feeling guilty 'cause you think he's cursed your name. Well, brothers, we're all sinners, each and every one the same. It's so hard to be an angel with that devil in the way. Will you take the hand of Jesus, let him purify your soul? Will you take that path to heaven with those streets all lined with gold? We're gonna welcome anyone, anyone who stumbles by. Brother, tell me if you want that old place beyond the sky. Will you take the hand?
And you got all the lyrics right, yeah?
No, I didn't.
You didn't, okay.
I was stumbling big time.
Okay.
It's so new, though, but I'm, you know, it's kind of, I mean, I don't know why I have this fear about talking too much about God, but I gotta spit this out, you know, while you got me on the gospel stuff. Is that
you're in Sweden, remember that.
I'm in Sweden, but I did, you know, I mean, I asked God when I just got up one day and I asked God to help me out write a gospel song, because I felt like I was ready to, like, you know, pay him back for all he's done for me. And I did get up just a week ago and the song just kind of spat out, you know, it just kind of came out of me.
Do people in Sweden talk about you with God? About God? With you about God?
I talk to them about it, you know, but... I'm really scared that I might wind up talking too much about him, because he has been so good to me, but I try to keep things vague sometimes for them. You know, when you're out in a venue and people are drinking a beer and stuff, you really kind of be caught a little bit cautious, you know. You don't want to get too heavy about the religion when people are out there doing what they do, you know. So
your home country, the US, do they know who Dog Seegers is?
I'm starting to get some, actually I call it a bleed over from Sweden, because there's just so much going on here, and you know, and I'm on the phone like just about every night talking to, you know, people in Nashville. I'm in the process of setting up a lot of stuff for me when I do get back home. We've got the record that's going to be released in October. This first record here has not even been released in the States yet, but it's going to be released in early October.
So the Swedes have to wait here for you to come back, because I read about your autumn tour was cancelled.
Yeah, well, that was kind of that's kind of hard to talk about, because the buzz was going so strong there. You know, one of the guys that was booking me, he kind of just took a step a little too quick there.
Okay.
And then America and Sweden were kind of butting horns together there, because, you know, you had one side wanting me to do one thing, and then Swedish people wanted me to do something else. And we got talking back in America, and we thought, well, you're doing 3 months, you know, you need a little rest, don't you? You know, why don't you come back home for a while, and you could always go back to Sweden next summer, you know, And that's pretty much, I think, what we all finally decide would work best for my career, you know.
Can you say no, the word no, to someone?
You know what? You know, my wife always hated me because I never knew how to say no to the children, you know. I have a hard time saying no, yeah, I do.
What happens inside you when you are on stage? Can you describe that, the feelings inside you when you sit there or stand there? Evening after evening.
When I'm playing for my fans, when I'm playing for my adorable fans who are so happy to come and see me, I mean, they must be happy. All the shows have been sold out everywhere, been playing. The show's been sold out. It's just beyond me. I mean, it's like something that I'm still absorbing myself. Like, how could I be this, you know, how could there be so much of this going on for me? I mean, it's hard for me, you know, just to think about me being that recognized.
But you must feel I'm the king of the world or something like that when you get all this positivity.
I don't want to feel that way. You know, I want to feel like a regular guy singing for children out on the street is what I want to feel like. I want to feel like a person that's reaching out to everybody, no matter where I am, you know. I don't want that big shit, the big shot, excuse me. I don't want that big shot image, or I don't want to be thinking that way at all. I really don't. I had a girl come up to me. Let me tell you a quick little story about really where I'm coming from, because this is what I'm trying to stay focused on. I'm going to do my damned hardest to try to accomplish this. But I had a girl come up to me after one of my shows about a week ago, and she had a blank piece of paper in her hand, and she had a pen in her hand, and she come up to me. She said, Mr. Seegers, I really need to ask you a big favor. And I said, what's that, ma'am? She said, my husband's an alcoholic, and it would mean so much to him and me both if you could just possibly write some words of inspire him in some way to help him to maybe think about, you know, what he's doing to himself. And I said, I'll be glad to do that, ma'am. Give me that paper. And I wrote down, some words of inspiration, and it just meant so much to her. It had me in tears when I walked away. Mm-hmm. And that's pretty much, you know, that to me is so special. You know, that's more, that has nothing to do with the fame and the fortune. It has nothing to do with it. That's really where I want to go with this.
Okay, there might come tears from the audience, I think, right now. Is it possible for you to take a last song in this?
Absolutely. Oh,
you never stop. I'm very happy. Thank you, Doug Seegers, for coming here.
Thank you very much.
I'm that little boy with glasses, the one they call the geek. A little girl that never smiles, 'cause I got braces on my teeth. And I know what it's like to cry myself to sleep. I'm that kid on every playground, the one that's chosen last. I'm that single teenage mother trying to overcome her past. You don't have to be my friend, but is it too much to ask? Don't laugh at me, don't call me names, don't get your pleasure from my pain. In God's eyes, we're all the same. Someday we'll all have perfect wings. Don't laugh at me. I'm that cripple on the corner, you've passed me on the street. And I wouldn't be out here begging if I had enough to eat. So don't think that I don't notice when your eyes don't meet mine. I lost my wife and little children when someone crossed that yellow line. The day we laid them in the ground is the day I lost my mind. Right now I'm down with nothing holding this cardboard sign. Don't laugh at me, don't call me names, don't get your pleasure from my pain. In God's eyes, we're all the same. Someday we'll all have perfect wings. Don't laugh at me. Someday we'll all have perfect wings. Don't laugh at me.